What's up, everybody? In this quick video, I'm going to show you how to use OSD on-screen display in your games without MSI Afterburner. If you want anything to be honest, MSI Afterburner is one of the best out there. And if you search on YouTube for any app for OSD, that is the first thing you're going to see: on-screen display. If you want to have this option without MSI Afterburner, whatever reasons, maybe you want to still use the app that comes with your GPU if you're on a desktop, or you just don't want to use MSI Afterburner but you want the ability to use on-screen display, in this video I'm going to show you how to do it. So let's go straight to the point. For me, I don't necessarily need MSI Afterburner because I already have an overclocking software which is baked into my laptop, which is called Predator Sense. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to get OSD without MSI Afterburner. So the two software you need is, you need HWiNFO 64 and River Tuna Statistics Server. You need both of them. I'm going to put the link in the description for quick access. So the next thing you need to do is to install both of them, which I already did in this video. First of all, you launch the River Tuna Statistics Server. It's going to come into your tray. So the next thing you're going to do is turn on this Show Statistics, or you can leave it off because HWiNFO is going to feed its own statistics. Then another thing you need to be sure it is turned on is on-screen display support. Just turn this on. Now, second thing you have to do is to launch HWiNFO 64. Click on sensor only and click on start. So it's going to give you some, I have an update, I'm going to do that later. So it's going to give you the sensor status of your computer, everything you need to know about your computer, from your CPU to your hard drive, all the sensors. So what we are going to be looking for now is the OSD, which is the on-screen display. You go to your settings, configure sensor. Now go to OSD, you will see where it says OSD in brackets ROTSS. This is River Tuna Statistics Server. You click on it. Now it's going to show you a bunch of sensors supported by River Tuna Statistics Server. And in my opinion, this is much better than what MSI Afterburner can offer because it has loads of sensors. You can see it has more sensors, even your total RAM power, system agent power, everything you need is here. So there are so many sensors here than MSI Afterburner. But in my opinion, I'm going to keep everything simple. All I need to display is my laptop GPU temperature, CPU temperature, and FPS. That's all I need. So if you see the sensor you want to display, for example, core temperature, that's the CPU temperature, you click on Show value in OSD, and you can change the color if you want, because that's the color I use to differentiate them. I use blue for my CPU, and for the GPU I used green, of course, because it is an NVIDIA. So where is it? Let me look for it. Okay, is the GPU. GPU temperature, you click on Show value in OSD. You can also change the color if you want. And lastly, frame rate. You can also add, if you want to add your frame rate 1% low and frame rate time, you can also add those. So These are the stuff I selected. And if you can also select the lines and the columns. You can just tweak it the way you want. My FPS is going to be on third line. My CPU temp is going to be on the second line. You can see right here. Yeah, second line. And my GPU temperature will be on the first line. I'm going to show you how it looks, by the way. So when you are done with setting up everything, you just click on OK. You can go ahead and minimize this. I'm going to show you how it looks in a game. Okay guys, this is how it looks in game. Like I said earlier, I'm going to keep everything simple. I have my GPU temperature showed in green, my CPU temperature showed in blue, and my FPS showed in white. So this is how I want it to be. You can add atmosphere sensor if you want. You can add your RAM usage and all that. So this is how to get it done without MSI Afterburner. If you find this video helpful, subscribe to my channel for more useful tutorial like this, and like the video. Anyway, that'll be all for this video. See you guys in the next one. Peace out.